All right, little moon day update, a lunar update, although I don't know how much of it's going to really be about the moon, but we'll see. I'll start with that. The new moon is coming up, so the moon is waning, getting dark. Where I'm at, it's just about to descend. It's been out during the day, and I haven't actually seen it. You know, it's been just a sliver out there. Again, coming up to the new moon. Currently in Taurus, and the energy right now is one of just putting things in place, practicality, preparing, this type of feeling. We're about to move into Gemini for the new moon. And that, the Gemini energy has been coming up. It's been really important over the past month, since the full moon. And yeah, it's really coming full circle, but here it's the new moon. And you know, the Gemini energy previously was very much about disparates coming together, right? Disparate souls, disparate points of view. And I think in the world we were seeing that around, you know, certain world events that were bringing people together, even though maybe they normally would disagree about things, bringing people together. Around, you know, certain ideas, certain things going on in the world, you know, things like, you know, the war in Gaza and all the atrocities happening there, and, you know, government and military overreach, and, you know, these types of things. So bringing a lot of people together who normally would not think the same things, who normally would not have the same ideas about some of this. And we're still in that, but what's coming through right now in terms of the moon, the lunar energy, is a sense of right now we can't see that Gemini energy. We can't see that sense of coming together. It's a little hidden. There's something mysterious happening right now, and it's everyone kind of preparing. It's this sort of Aries individual energy coming now into the Taurus energy, where the moon is right now. It's very practical. And then this Gemini energy hitting at the new moon. And what's coming through is to stay the course, keep the faith, keep your vibration up, because things might feel really bad over these next few days. Could be worldwide, you know, globally, could be, you know, nationally, where you are, locally, or regionally. Could be personally with your own, individual relationships. There's some sense of almost like important relationship that is there. It is solid, but it's not showing itself right now. And to the important thing is to get through the night, right? Because it's gonna pop back out, right? The moon's gonna get through its new moon phase, and it's gonna start waxing again, and there's gonna be light, and you know, the moon will start coming out at night again and make the night brighter. It won't be out during the day when it doesn't do so much, right? Some of these types of things. Along with that, coming through heavily today is the word simplicity. And just a whole bunch of stuff just came pouring through in terms of simplify your life. And that is a big message right now that's coming through, is to simplify. We've lived through a time where our literally our economy, and therefore everyone's well-being, has depended on making everything as complex as possible. And we are now moving into a time when, for some of us, that's not going to be the choice anymore. For some of us, we're choosing to simplify. We're choosing simplicity over all that complexity. And why this is important and how it's connected to that Gemini energy in the new moon is you might think you're the only one who's feeling that way, who's doing that, who's going through that, who feels that pull or that push in that direction. And no, it's not. It's just that right now we're doing it individually. We're going through a time right now where we're simplifying. What does that mean? Well, it can mean a lot of different things. It can be, what was coming through for me was a lot of what I've tried to do in my life is things like, look, we don't need so many, all these products that we're, that we buy, 10 million different cleaning products and, maximum strength and yada, yada, yada. It's like, I have basically one powder cleaner that basically does everything. It doesn't have water in it. It keeps our water where it should be. Any water I use is used in my local environment. It goes back down into that environment. And it stays there, right? Because one of the big things in Gaia is all over this. It's one of the most important things. If you're out in unbuilt spaces and you're listening in, the trees are speaking to you, the waters are speaking to you, everything has been saying, keep the waters where they are. Hands off the waters. And so, if you're using, liquid soaps, there's water in that. And that water gets pulled up from somewhere and shipped all over the world. And it does never go back there. And that's a problem. And simplify. Powdered cleaners, powdered soaps. Using less bottled water, stuff that's being shipped in from all over the place, where you have water where you are. Learn how to deal with it. Learn how to clean it if you need to be able to use it for different things. Things like harvesting rainwater for the different uses that can be made for. I'm thinking of it right now. I have a situation where I could easily use some harvested rainwater for things I'm doing, and it would be better, so I should do that. Simplifying. What can you do for out of your own backyard? What can you do less of? There's a sense of cleansing along with simplifying. You might be feeling like chopping your hair or growing out your hair or, shaving your beard or growing a beard. You might be, thinking about cleansing your body, bathing, taking baths. Highly recommend taking baths, or go to, a body of water and soak in that water, get into that water. Just did that this last weekend, and it was, important for me. So, along with this idea of cleansing and simplifying, those two go together. So, for instance, when you're cleansing something, follow what I call the rule of three, right? Do it three times if you need to. A fourth if you absolutely have to. Don't keep cleaning the thing over and over and over and over and over. Three is enough of anything. Any action that you're doing repetitively, three is enough. Four if you absolutely have to, and that's it. Simplifying life, letting things go. Is it perfect yet? It doesn't matter. Went at it three times, maybe a fourth, and that's good enough. Good enough is good enough. We live in this world where sometimes we just will not accept anything as good enough. Good enough is good enough. Release yourself from that burden of having to have things just so, right? Rule of three, get three things done that are important to you every day and let other stuff slide. Understand the difference between the important and the urgent, right? The important and the urgent. Not everything is urgent, or not everything is important just because it's urgent. Learn to let the urgent slide. Some of these things we learned during the pandemic, and so it might be some of that stuff that might be coming back up. Maybe you've let it go, but it might be coming back up again. And You know, what I'm getting is that this is going to be important, and it's going to be important to everyone in different ways. One of the things that I've said recently is that different people might come to a message that I put out there, and we'll see different messages. And one of the things I've gotten with this one is going to be the same for everybody. This is a timeline point where it is, everything's coming together right now. It's all the same for everybody. And then it splits. It splits in all kinds of different directions. And so from here, different people will experience different things. And what you experience is going to be what your soul fragment wanted to experience, decided to experience, even if it's a bit awful, even if it's tough, even if it's things that you think, I would never choose that for myself. If you're watching this, then you're awakened in a way where you're aware of more. You're aware that you have a quote-unquote higher version of yourself, a version of yourself that can see from a higher vantage point, that sees a wider field, that sees more. It's not so much that it's higher or better, it's that you can see more, you're aware of more. And sometimes to get to where you want to go, you have to go through some shit. And that's coming through right now. Some of us are going to be choosing to go through some shit, even if it doesn't feel like we're choosing it. And it will be a choice made at a higher level. And some of us are starting to become aware of that, or have already been aware of that, or are becoming more aware of it. And it's, you know, this could be intense for some of us. I'm not making specific predictions because it's going to be different for everybody and different timelines. So it's, I'm talking about timeline splitting, where each of us is in each of those timelines experiencing something different. And there's a fragment of you that's in this one. It's in the one that's going to continue from this point. You watching this video, you listening to this message, and then you're going to go on. And this version of you is going to do certain things, is going to see certain things. And right now you're preparing for that. You're simplifying, you're cleansing in the ways that feel right to you. It may be almost like the idea of nesting, right? Like, I just have to do this. I have to get this done. I have to clean this. I have to remove this from my life. I have to get rid of this, whatever it might be. Or I need these items. I need to be able to do these actions. So I need these items so I can do these actions. And it may be very out of the blue. It may be very spiritual things. It might be quite mundane things, right? It could be, I need this tarot deck. And you don't even know which one, but you go look for it and there it is, and you know that's the one. It could be, you know, crystals that you need to work with. It could be natural stones that you pick up on a walk that you need to work with. It could be going back to some place that you knew as a child and being in that space. It could be lots of different things. It could be releasing things. It could be releasing people from your life. It could be, leaving a job. I'm not suggesting everyone go leave their job, but for somebody, it could be that. A relationship might need to be left behind. Different things. So, this is kind of a very intense period that we're in, that we're coming up to. That's what's coming through right now. If you are on such a journey, you need some support with it, please do reach out to me. There'll be ways to reach out in the description to this video. Appreciate liking, sharing, subscribing, leaving a comment. All of that helps. And very open to conversations, so bring that on in the comments, as long as it's respectful. And reach out to me in the other ways that are available, that I'll have in the video description. Sending you all kinds of love and peace at this time. Hang on for the ride. It's just the overall message right now. Hang on for the ride. Just because it gets dark just because maybe you can't see all of a sudden doesn't mean it's going to stay that way. So just hang on during that. Really kind of just let yourself get through it. New moon energy is a lot about releasing. So let things go that feel like you need to let it go. And then otherwise, just wait and see what comes out on the other side. It's a threshold moment. It's a threshold moment. A lot of things are coming together. Things are clicking into place. And the last thing I'll leave you then with is this is really important for the idea of what folks call the new earth, right? And so much of the time, and this is because of certain brands of Christianity and really Christianity in general, we get this idea that the world will just immediately change overnight and it'll all be great. And all the bad people will be gone and only the good people will be here. And then I don't have to worry about anything anymore. I can just live my life. That's really what it's all about, right? That line of thinking is I'm just sick and tired of being with other people that bug me, that aren't like me. Well, that's not what's happening. But it also is what's happening. The world is shifting. Things are clicking into place. If you know where to look for it, you can see it. It doesn't have to be all of us seeing it and going through it and being aware of it for it to happen. What's important for you during this time is to stay at that high vibration. Look through the eyes of the heart, with the eyes of love, from a higher vantage point. That heart-mind connection that I talk about. Look back at previous videos. If that's a new term to you or a new idea to you, I've talked about that before. And actually, that's a good reminder as well. I'm hearing from Spirit this is going to be probably the last message I give this week. I'm going into a bit of a hermit mode. I have some things that I need to get done. I have some writing I need to do that is very important right now. And yeah, when I come back out of that, whether it's a week or 2 weeks or however long it ends up being, I believe it'll be about a week, but maybe it will be longer. It's possible that it'll be a couple of weeks, maybe even 3 weeks. It may be even almost July before anybody here on YouTube hears from me again. I don't know. But what I do know is there's other videos already here. And a lot of that stuff, if you haven't watched it, there's something there for you probably. So go back through those. Use this time to go back through those. There's been a pretty deliberate sequence, even if it seems a bit random. I just follow with what's coming in at the time. I do expect a little more deliberateness coming in after this. And that's one of the reasons for the pause that I'm hearing. So expect that. Expect some other things to come along with it. That's it for now. Again, love and peace, sending you all the light you can stand, even though it might feel a little dark over the next few days. Remember, dark isn't evil. Darkness isn't evil. It's just darkness. What's in the shadows? It's an opportunity to find out. Keep your eyes open. Keep your heart open. And, keep clear in the head. All right. Bye now.